it's Desmina, and welcome to Beyond Science 2. Picture this, you are walking down a long boulevard, arm in arm with other protesters, chanting, shouting, and expressing your discontent with the day's political or social concern. You grow in number as you approach your rendezvous point, but halfway through your march, you are blocked by a wall of riot shields and the heavily guarded police to make sure that the protest does not go devastatingly awry. Unfortunately, things do not go as planned. Somehow, somewhere, someone started a ruckus and everything begins to fall apart. What was intended as a peaceful demonstration turned into a riot. Law enforcers begin to move in to subdue the violence and protesters begin to defend themselves from potential harm and abuse. And like a silent missile being shot into the sky, a silver tin canister flies above everyone's head, a thick white plume of what seems to be smoke trailing from behind it. People begin to disperse as the canister lands and the thick cloud of smoke-like vapor begins to spread and thicken. Panic ensues and people run away from it. Those who are unlucky get their senses bombarded with a stinging sensation that stabs the eyes and constricts the lungs and airways. It's tear gas. Tear gas is a collective term for lacrimatory agents that are a mixture of generally non-lethal compounds designed to irritate a respiratory system, and most commonly the eyes, which may incapacitate anyone with temporary blindness. These compounds are used by many for self-defense, but are most commonly employed by law enforcement officers and military to disperse large crowds or in much more dangerous missions. So what is tear gas and how does it work? As mentioned earlier, tear gas is a collective form for a number of different riot control agents. Despite its misleading namesake, it is not gaseous. Instead, it is an aerosol mixture of multiple compounds that are referred to as tear producers or lacrimators. Among these compounds is chloroacetophenone, or CN, which is present in mace sprays. Modern tear gas, on the other hand, employs other ingredients but can always be traced back to the most basic ingredient. CS was first developed and synthesized in the 1950s and became the replacement of the much more powerful CN. And to this day, it is still one of the most go-to non-lethal riot control agents. Though pepper spray may seem to have the same effects as tear gas, they are a little different because its effects are more inflammatory than lacrimatory. It is, however, more debilitating, but it is difficult to disperse, and so it is used most commonly as personal protection against assaults or wild animals. Despite being a lot less lethal than bullets, tear gas are still powerful irritants that can, upon contact with the skin, cause severe burning sensations, where prolonged exposure may cause severe rashes and chemical burns. When the agent reaches the eyes, the chemicals begin to react differently as the body begins to send signals to the brain, activating its natural defenses, sending out a flood of tears to wash out the irritant. This is where tear gas actually got its name. In severe cases, tear gas victims may experience temporary blindness, especially when exposed to the chemicals for a prolonged period of time. The chemical compounds in tear gas also have irritating effects to the respiratory. When inhaled, the substance kicks the immune system into hyperdrive, as the body begins to produce mucus and induces the person to cough and retch in order to keep the irritants out of the body and expel any that have been entered. In severe cases, the respiratory system becomes irritated that a person will find himself or herself having difficulty breathing and his upper respiratory tract tensing up. However, the damage done by tear gas is generally not permanent. Hours after exposure, the body goes back to normal as the effects subside. In rare cases where people are in constant, prolonged exposure to the chemicals, especially those who get severe allergic reactions to certain types of chemicals and substances, they may develop irreversible damage to the eyes, such as glaucoma. Even worse is death when the substance caused serious chemical burns inside the respiratory system that leads to cardiac arrest. Such was the case of a Palestinian woman in 2011 when she had prolonged exposure to tear gas during a protest at the West Bank. Now, what can be a temporary relief? In the news, people have been photographed pouring milk over their eyes and faces to alleviate the stinging pain from tear gas. It has been claimed by many that this homemade remedy has helped in getting rid of the effects of the lacrimatory agent. In the protest at Ferguson, demonstrators have been seen entering a local McDonald's and having milk poured all over their faces. Activists from Gaza and Israel, on the other hand, combat the fierce effects of tear gas by washing their faces with cola. Whatever the method, it would seem that there is an unspoken truth that you should not use water to wash up tear gas, because not only does it have no effect, but it also may increase the irritation. Several methods have been shared by people online. In a flyer published by individuals who are part of the 2011 Occupy movement, they advised people to use antacids dissolved in water to relieve the body of the effects of the chemicals. However, the U.S. Army Center for Health Promotion and Preventive Medicine and the New York Department of Health and Mental Hygiene hands out much detailed advice on relieving oneself of the effect of tear gas. Contrary to popular opinion, these two departments advise individuals who have been affected by tear gas to wash their eyes with clean water as soon as possible for at least 15 minutes in order to completely wash off harmful chemicals. difficult. If the gas has been inhaled, individuals are advised to get out of the affected area immediately and seek fresh air, breathing in and out, getting as much oxygen as possible. In cases where medics are present, these professionals may administer asthma medication in order to help air passages, especially in severe cases. If tear gas happens to enter through the mouth and ingested, individuals should drink plenty of water, and if they can, induce vomiting and seek immediate medical attention. Clothes that have been doused with chemicals should be washed separately from uncontaminated clothing and avoid using chlorine-based detergents to prevent harmful chemical reactions that may mix with the CS compound. So what's the legality of tear gas? While tear gas is considered non-lethal, there are laws surrounding and controlling the use of the substance. According to the Chemical Weapons Convention of 1993, tear gas is strictly banned in warfare, but in cases where domestic riots are concerned, it is perfectly legal to employ it. However, one expert pointed out the paradox of the legality of the use of tear gas. In a statement made by Sven Erik Jordic, a Yale University School of Medicine nerve gas expert, says that tear gas under the Geneva Convention is characterized as a chemical warfare agent, and so it is precluded for use in warfare, but it is used very frequently against civilians. That's very illogical. So I don't know, this gas seems pretty harmful, but what are your thoughts? Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye!